we're here to explore our curly hair.
You need to call me and remind me to wash my hair.
My hair routine takes 2 days.
So I just use a normal, like, cotton towel. Curly hair community's like, Jackie, no!
What's up, y'all? Welcome back to Clever Style.
Hi.
You guys, we are here today to do something really, really, really exciting. Mm-hmm. We're here to explore curly hair, but more specifically, our curly hair.
Yes! I have been waiting for this moment for a long time. It's an exciting day!
It's super exciting. Totally. You guys will fully get to see our different routines mm-hmm. and the different products that we use.
It's always good to keep the curly hair combo going because totally. For all three of us, we all have like crazy hair journeys.
Yep. So my curly hair type teeter-totters between wavy and like curly, not like kinky curls, but very like loose curls. When I was younger, I did have tighter curls, but at the tender age of, I think maybe 9 or 10, that's when I wanted to start straightening it. And I straightened my hair all the way up till about 20.
Damn!
Maybe wore it curly like once or twice a year. My curls have drastically changed from wavy to like they're starting to little baby little spiral.
For sure. I have the same issues. Also, a lot of mine stem from a very emotional place because moving from South Africa, I just wanted to fit in. Nobody had hair like me. I have extremely thick hair. It is very curly, but I am in the process of having to kind of get my hair back to a good place because I only stopped straightening my hair last year. And I have definitely seen a difference for sure. I still have a lot of areas and issues with damage and dryness and breakage mm-hmm. and just not growing, my hair isn't growing as much, but it for me, I'm still in that like fighting my own mindset that I'm still attractive when my hair is curly mm-hmm. or just as attractive as when my hair is straight. Feeling
it's
like
so
curly
hard.
Hair doesn't go with clothes or certain outfits, and also trying to then also just take better care of my hair.
I was the lone chocolate chip in the cookie growing up in my schooling, you know?
Same.
So I was like, oh, I want to fit in. I want to have straight hair like the other girls. So I got a perm in sixth grade
Dang.
To yep. straighten my hair. Yep. And I, to this day, am so upset that I did it because mm-hmm. my hair was so long. It was so long. I didn't start wearing my hair naturally until last year, which is
Dang,
just
y'all.
So wild. Yeah, mm-hmm. I wore braids first before the perm. And braids are great for my texture because it's a protective style. So
right,
it makes your
right.
hair grow because you're right. not constantly touching it and manipulating it. So that's why my hair was so healthy and long when I was little. Mm. So I stopped perming my hair in college and then I started wearing braids again. And then that's how most of you guys knew me with braids for years.
Right.
And then last year wasn't until, it sounds so like me, until I signed with my modeling agency that my agent was like, I think you should wear your hair naturally. And I never thought, I always liked when my hair was natural. I was like, oh,
yeah.
it looks so good. But the upkeep of it all, I was like, I'm not gonna do that. But then when she said that, I was like, okay, cool.
I have such mad respect for you just being like, hell yeah, let's do it.
Because you fully embrace it.
Yeah,
and not
yeah.
only that, you own it mm-hmm. with confidence too. And I think that's, it's challenging for everybody.
Yeah, Thanks because at the end of the day, like that is our hair.
I don't know who needs to hear it, but how remarkable is it that this naturally grows out of your scalp?
I know.
Right? Like, yeah, you know what I mean?
We sit here always trying to change it.
Yeah. It's like, this is some reality
shit. Yeah. No, it's so true.
You know what
so
I mean? Like,
true.
Whatever your hair texture is, just like you were made that way for a reason. Not to say that you can't straighten your hair. Like, if you want to switch it up or whatever. But, like, embrace what you're working with.
There's someone watching this right now that has Drew's style type of hair, Sinead's type of hair, my type of hair. And I think I've never seen a curly hair video online where they have three different women
Me
with
either.
Three different textures and showing the full process. So I know I'm excited to see it. I'm gonna go first. I feel like my process is the fastest just because I have thinner hair and there's just less steps. So if you have my texture and you want in out the door and have somewhat good results, follow this. I'll be honest, my hair doesn't have the best results all the time, but it looks decent.
It looks great.
It looks
and
good.
You know, I'm ready to go in an hour, you know? Okay. So the products I use for shampoo and conditioner, I love Shea Moisture. Mm-hmm. I just love the smell. I'm a huge coconut person, so Whenever there's any product with a coconut smell, I'm like, hell yeah, I want that. But before I do shampoo and conditioner, depending on what my week is like, I'll do a deep conditioner first. I'll be in the shower, I'll put the deep conditioner in, I'll get out of the shower, let it sit for 30 minutes, get back in the shower, wash it out, and then I'll start with my shampoo and conditioner. Shampoo, I lather it up, I make sure to put a lot of it in my hand, and start from the scalp all the way to the bottom, you know? Gotta like really get in there with your fingers. Because the thing about our products too is you'll leave it in for maybe 3, 4, 5 days sometimes. So it's really important for you to clean your scalp because you get all that buildup, and all that buildup doesn't help your hair grow. When I do the conditioner, I definitely do not put it on the top of my hair because I have an issue with volume. My hair definitely weighs down, and I've always had an issue with that. I don't like that it's like all like flat to my scalp. So I'll try to avoid putting the conditioner so close to the cuticles because I want it to just be weightless. So I'll just actually put the conditioner at the bottom of my hair.
How long do you condition?
I literally put it in my hair and I'll wash my body and then I'll rinse it out.
Wow.
Honest to God, only use the conditioner in the shower because you're supposed to use conditioner and because it helps brushing out the tangles. But other than that, that's the only reason why I use it is to brush out the tangles. I honestly end up washing my hair every other day because for me, yeah, I know. Honestly, I don't need to wash it like that.
You need to call me and remind me to wash my hair.
It's if I have some more to go. And because my hair doesn't take that long to get ready, I'll just wash it all over again. If I don't have anywhere to go, I'll maybe go 3 to 4 days without washing my hair. While I'm in the shower and I have the conditioner in my hair, that's when I'll brush it out. It's definitely, I get a lot of knots in my hair and I wanna detangle it in the shower before I get out of the shower, just to skip that process, and I want it to be really wet. It's really good to brush your knots out when your hair is wet rather than dry because you don't want that breakage. So now I'm ready to get out of the shower. So that is my washing, and that altogether takes about 10 minutes.
Wow. That's insane.
It's time to get in the shower with Snake. I sometimes can go days without washing it and not feel like it's very dirty, and sometimes I go even longer.
I
get it.
After all of those days, I have a lot of product or buildup and whatever in my hair. So I will use either an apple cider vinegar shampoo, like the Wow shampoo, or I will use these babies from IGK, which is the coconut milk anti-frizz shampoo and conditioner. It's incredible, it smells amazing, and it's also not a foaming one. It's like an actual milk shampoo, so it doesn't soap up, which is good for me because I have very frizzy hair at the moment. So I'll use this. But if it's been days and days and days, then I have to start with the pre-shampoo oil. It helps break down anything, and it's also really like nourishing and moisturizing. So I will have to start with the pre-shampoo oil and just to kind of help make it softer and easier to manage in the shower. And then I will shampoo and condition with the IGK. The IGK is great just because I noticed that when I use the shampoos that foam up, it just strips my hair of a lot of like the natural moisture. And because my hair is so damaged right now, I need to hold on to all the moisture I can get.
Moist.
And then after I'm done shampooing, I will use this IGK 3-minute mask, hydration mask. 3 minutes, I like to keep it in for a hell of a lot longer than 3 minutes. If I could keep this mask in for 3 minutes and be great, I would be a happy, happy person. But it is a hydration hair mask. It's like a deep conditioning mask. The longest I've kept it in was like 4 hours one time.
Wow.
But yeah, so I will try to at least keep it in for like 20 to 30 minutes. So now after I rinse the hydration mask out, if I'm having a day where my hair is so bad, then I will just add conditioner right on top of that, honestly. And then I will start brushing. I use the Tracee Ellis Ross Pattern Beauty Brush. I freaking love this brush. A lot of people have complaints about this brush. They say it pulls out all their hair. I don't mind because my hair is so thick that I'm just like, hell yeah.
Damn,
I'm just like, get in there. And then I gotta rinse. Sometimes, Sometimes I will rinse. Well, I got a new shower filter because I realized that wasn't helping my issue. Take a look at your shower head and how much stuff is coming through it, because that made a huge difference. So now I have a filtered shower head, and then I will brush as I rinse just to make sure I get all that product out. All the product has to be out of my hair. It just does something to my hair and it like makes it drier. So then I get out of the shower.
Free at last.
Yeah, God.
We did it. We did it, Joe.
Okay, it's my turn.
Y'all ready for this journey?
Are you ready for this journey? Okay, first, because I don't think I said it yet, my hair is kinky, coily, and if you're gonna go off of the letter chart, first of all, the different textures, there's multiple different textures in here, so I'm somewhere in between 4B, 4C, somewhere in there. So just so you know, if you're in that spectrum. So first of all, my hair routine takes 2 days.
Say what?
And because it takes 2 days, I will go forever before I wash my hair. I would say normally I'll go like a month. It doesn't get oily. It will just look like this all the time. So therefore, I'm like, well, why do it?
Yeah.
And the reason why I do it is because I'm like, bitch, you stink, so wash your hair. Now I'm trying to commit to like every 2 weeks because that's healthier for my hair, but we will see.
When's the last time that you washed your hair?
This is 2 weeks ago.
2 weeks, and yeah. It's so insane that your hair can look like you literally washed it, styled.
Totally,
like,
right?
Okay, so because I go a long time without washing my hair will get dry, and that's why I'm so thankful to Palmers, because they came out with the Coconut Oil Formula Moisture Boost Collection, which is all about if your hair is damaged, or if it's dry, or if it's brittle, it's gonna restore that moisture, and it's gonna give you that shine that you want. You guys have heard me talk about Palmers multiple times. Mm-hmm. I just love their stuff. So the first thing I'll start out with is the Coconut Oil Formula Moisture Boost Shampoo. I get under the shower head, and I soak my hair in water first, and then I'll go in with the shampoo, and I'll just lather it on up. Just keep on lathering, it smells so good. And so it takes a while to work through, and you just want to make sure that you're really getting to your scalp and all of, you know, just everything. So I'll shampoo twice, I'll rinse that out, and then it's time to condition. And before I condition my hair, I try to wring out my hair as much as I can so that it's dry, so it's not dripping wet before because I want the conditioner to really like
that makes
soak
sense.
Up in
there. Ooh, I'm gonna start doing it.
Yeah. Yeah. So then I'll go in with the Moisture Boost Conditioner, which is great. Again, also smells amazing like the shampoo does. And this is the process that takes a little bit longer. So what's great about Palmer's is they have this conditioner, but then they also have specifically a deep conditioner. Mm. So I'll go in with this conditioner and I'll like leave that on for like 5 minutes. And then I'll rinse that out in the shower and then again do the whole wringing out situation. And then I'll go in with the deep conditioner. So I put the deep conditioner on my hair, and again, I'm really making sure I'm getting to the roots. And the ends of my hair are really important because the ends of your hair are the oldest part of your mm-hmm. hair. So like that's the part that really needs the moisture. And so I will get out of the shower and I'll go in with this, I believe it's called the Easy Detangler Brush.
I've seen those, those look
Whoa,
amazing.
Whoa, that's like from
yeah.
the future.
So it's like, sorry, kind of gross because I use it all the time, but you can move this little rod to be down here if you have looser curls, but I have obviously like really Whoa. Tight textured curls. So I use this top layer, and what I'll do is I'll get out and part my hair into sections. And so I'll apply the conditioner while I'm in the shower, but this is really the part where I'm really getting in there. I'll apply the deep conditioner to sections, and I'm breaking through my hair with the conditioner as I go. So
yeah.
I'm detangling my hair while it has the conditioner in it. Mm-hmm. And with my hair texture, it's really important to start from the ends and work your way up. Mm-hmm. Because if you try to comb from the scalp,
just get stuck.
You will be bald, okay?
Yeah.
It will not work. So you definitely have to work from your ends and work your way up. And then once I run the comb through, then I'll usually just twist it and it'll look like all foamy. And then I'll wrap it and like make like a little knot basically. And it's really just like sectioning my hair so I keep it in sections. Once I have it all deep conditioned, I'll put a shower cap on while it's in like the little knots, and I will sit for an hour. So I'm sitting, this is the part that's like, it really hurts your soul because you're out of the shower, you're sitting in your robe, getting all cozy, watching a show, perhaps eating dinner. And then it's like, oh yeah, I have to get back in the shower.
Yeah,
I have to go
no.
back into water, and it makes it's something to get over. But I'm used.
It's like an intermission of your shower.
So then I go back into the shower, and I am rinsing out the deep conditioner. But it's okay if you leave some of the conditioner in if you have my texture of hair, because it's not gonna do anything but moisture your hair. It's good for it, you know. Yeah. So before I get out, I just try to, ring dry it as much as I can.
It is imperative that when I get out of the shower, I keep my hair as wet as possible, because that's the best way to keep it styled. If my hair gets dry or too dry and then I put product in it, like, it gets frizzy. Mm-hmm. You're supposed to use microfiber towels for your hair. You know, for some reason, mine just always go disappearing. So I just use a normal, cotton towel. Ah! Curly hair community's like, Jackie, no! So again, I'm out of the shower and I'll brush it normally first, right? But then I'll flip my head upside down and I'm brushing it. So now this is the position I'm in for a good 20 minutes and I can't move. And this is now when I'm gonna start putting my products in. If my hair is not as wet as I need to be, this is a lifesaver. I love this little mister.
Yes, I love those.
It's just so good. It's like not direct wetness. It just gives you exactly what you need. So I always have this on standby just in case. Now that my hair is super wet, this is the products that I use. So I use different products throughout the process, right? Mm-hmm. The first two that I put in, I definitely put Moroccan oil. I freaking love the smell of this. For me, it's all about how your hair smells. So the Moroccan oil is a mousse. So I'll do 3 to 4 pumps of this.
I'll get the back of it, I'll get the front of it, and then I scrunch, 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 scrunch. The word is scrunch. You just keep scrunching. Get it all in there. Then I will go in with Mizani.
Ooh, that stuff's good.
Smells good too. Oh God.
It smells so good.
Does it?
Yes. So good.
The Mizani is a styling gel. It's it's almost a mousse too, really. The texture is mousse-like, but it's more of a styling gel. What I'm trying to always do is get more volume. So whenever I use creams or anything like that, it weighs my hair down. So that's why I tend to go with mousses, because it's lighter on the hair. So now I have 4 pumps of this and I'm crunching and a moussing and crunch, crunch, crunch. Now, there's 2 differences. There is the curly hair, get it done and go. So you just crunch, you don't rebrush it or anything. And then there's the other, if you're really trying to go all out, you take this afterwards and you use it with each strand and you flip the hair to create a curl and then you crunch. So there's 2 different variations. One, it's like easy hair, wave beach go. The other is more defined curls, and you use this brush to do that. I bought this brush maybe 2 years ago, and it definitely makes your curls different. So now I have these products in, right? And this is when I bring in the diffuser. As I diffuse, your hair's starting to dry and you can tell if it's starting to get frizzy or if the product's holding in the curls. If it's not holding in the curls and I didn't put enough and it starts to frizz a little bit, I'll take the gel. I just use any kind of gel, but Giovanni is really good too. So I'll take the styling gel and I'll just put a little bit on my hand so that it's not super sticky and it's more water-like. And then I'll just caress the outside of my hair where it starts getting frizzy, just to tame it a little bit. And then when you let it air dry, you can kind of see where it's starting to get frizzy. And if it does get frizzy, that's when you put in these other products. So that's pretty much it. Not very hard. It's just really about diffusing, air drying, and making sure that you have enough products where it's starting to get frizzy. I'm normally out the house at this point, but if I have time, I think it'll literally take 1.5 hours for my hair to completely dry. But to be honest, the roots are a little still wet and it's in the process. But if it's completely dry before I leave, the last finishing touch when my hair's done, I love this again. It's Mizani. It's so good. You could use any coconut oil or anything, but it's just a nourishing oil. So at the end, it just gives it that extra shine to look all shiny and glistening. And it smells so delicious.
It smells so good.
So it's a nice way to top it off. Now, you're not supposed to use hairspray at all with curly hair. It's just, you don't get, because you don't get more days out of your curly hair. If you use hairspray, it starts getting natted together. Crunchy. So the second day, the curls won't be as good. So I'll try to avoid hairspray, but again, because I don't have beautiful volume like these women over here, sometimes you just want the inches,
Right.
And I'm like, damn, my hair's not doing what it needs to do. So I'll go in with the hairspray. But that's it. And then after that, I'm done.
Okay, so I'm gonna wring out my hair a little bit. That's when I use the pattern microfiber towel.
Jackie.
I know.
Add to cart.
Jackie, I know.
Click the link in the description.
I know.
If my microfiber towel is in the wash or it goes disappearing, I use a t-shirt before I use a towel. So yeah, so it's great. Obviously, you guys will see how I use it.
Nice.
It's so nice.
Yeah, it's
very
nice.
It's got one curved edge on the bottom, and that is the part that goes around your head, and then you just tuck it right in there. So it becomes like a little hair turban,
cute.
Right? I noticed an immediate difference the first time I ever used a microfiber towel. I swear my hair is curlier once I take the towel out. It's more moisturized, it's softer, it's just better. And then I will keep my hair in that towel maybe 5 minutes. If I have nowhere to go and I don't necessarily feel like styling it and I don't mind it being a gigantic frizz ball for the rest of the day, I will keep it in this towel with an oil or some other sort of leave-in for the rest of the day. We move on to the rest of it. So, we have, back to IGK. They have a lot of great products for damage. So this Good Behavior Spray, it's a 4-in-1 prep spray. It's a styling spray, but it's also a heat protector, and it's also a 24-hour frizz control and a detangler. So if you're having an extra nasty day, I will spray my hair with this. Okay, so when that's on, then we have the two curly products, okay? And this really helps with the part of my hair that doesn't curl very easily, right? Like it's not, I need extra help to get it to curl. But yeah, so I'll use that. And then I also have the Aveda B Curly Curl Enhancer. And between these two, I feel like this covers my bases on, I need things to weigh my hair down a little bit, add a little bit too, because it's so thick and it's so frizzy and fluffy. I wanna get like the curl, the hair to kind of come together into a curl, you know? And then, I'm going to use a gel. So this is a length retention defining hair gel. It adds the right type of one smell, and it's a really great finishing product, and it's really good for like styling. When you wanna go in and really style your hair, you're gonna use something like this. After putting these products in, I'm then gonna let my hair air dry for a bit, like walk around, you know, take a few laps, whatever. I usually try to let it air dry for at least like 30 minutes to an hour.
Mm-hmm.
And then I will go to diffuse it just because it's just better. It's just better to let your hair air dry, especially if you have some product in it. Let the products work, and then you can go in and diffuse it just to kind of like seal it in. And if you really gotta go somewhere, then diffuse it, you know? After I diffuse it, that's usually when I'll put in something like a gel, and then I'll just put my pomade in my purse for touch-ups throughout the day.
I looked over at Jackie's face midway through, and she was like, oh my God, it's still going?
It ain't over till it's over.
So, and this part's important. A lot of people do what's called the greenhouse method. I don't do that, but I usually will take a t-shirt, squeeze out as much water as I can, but I don't wanna completely dry it because, like Jackie said, it's good to comb through your hair when it's wet. And so then I'll go in with the Moisture Boost Leave-In Conditioner. And this is great just because, again, more moisture to your hair, and it's gonna make it easier for the comb to go through. So I'll spray in the leave-in conditioner, and then I'm taking those little knots apart and then going through with my brush again just to make sure everything is good to go where it needs to be. Now I'm going about to blow dry my hair. So I found this handy dandy.
Oh, what is that?
I think Revlon makes it. It's a blow dryer, but it's also a comb.
What?
With my texture of hair, you can't just blow dry it. It needs to have a comb going through it because you're stretching the hair and you're making sure it doesn't get tangled. With the style that I do with like the more defined curls, mm-hmm. That's why I'm blow drying my hair first, because I'm gonna go in and do with my rods. You can also do a braid out or a twist out, which is when your hair is wet and then you just like twist it and then you sleep in that and then it's good to go. But what I'm gonna show you guys today, I use the rod. So I go in with this blow dryer, which is great because the heat's coming out of this, and it's also a comb, so 2-in-1 saved my life.
Your whole head with that?
Yeah, it cut down the time so much, and I'm so thankful for this. This one has a high and cool temperature. I always put it on low, and with the leave-in conditioner on it, I'll blow dry through my hair in sections, again, because I need to keep them in sections to keep it managed. So that takes a while. Also, this makes it so straight. It's like, it's shocking. You'll see when I'm doing it. I'll go through each section and I'll blow dry it. And so now my hair is fully blow dried and I've gained at least 3 biceps because, oh my God, it's so much. This, your hands are constantly like this and it's a lot. So then I'll go in with the Moisture Boost Hair and Scalp Oil. I should really oil my scalp every day. Mm-hmm. It's just good to oil your scalp and massage it because it stimulates growth. And that's what I want. And that's just to add that shine. And it's good for your hair, again, for moisture. So now I'm going in with my flexi rods. Before I do that, I'll add this curl defining cream. And I'll use, similar to the spray bottle that Jackie had, the mister, I'll mist a little bit onto my hair, which I know sounds crazy because you're like, bitch, you just blow dried it. Yeah. But in order to get the defined curls that I want, I have to add some water type of moisture. So I'll spray it a little bit. And then I'll go in with the curl defining cream, and that will just really help your hair to form to whatever form you're trying to make. I go in each section, and there's no really method to this madness. I just wrap the ends first, and then I'll go up and do like a, and then it's up. And then I'll sleep in that overnight. So then we are going to day 2. Is it comfortable to sleep in? Hell no.
Do you have to wrap it? Do you have to do anything while you sleep?
Well, I don't wrap it because I want air to get to it because the whole point is to dry it with the creams and whatever on it so that it holds the curl. So I sleep on a satin or silk pillowcase, which I'm sure that we all can relate to, regardless of what type of hair you have, but especially curly hair, it's just way better for your hair. It prevents breakage. So then I wake up in the morning, slight crook in my neck because ooh, those real arms. I wake up and now it's time to take the flexi rods out. So while I'm doing that, I'll go back with the hair and scalp oil, and I'm really just lathering this onto my fingers because it's good that when you take the flexi rods out, just to have some type of, not a lot of oil, but some oil to help separate the curls so that they stay defined and so that you're not making them frizzy. You need to take your time when you do this because if you're trying to go quick with it, you're gonna mess up the style. And you've already put in 5 years in the day at this point. Now I'm going in, I already pulled apart my curls with the scalp and hair oil on my hands, but now I'm gonna go in with the hair polisher serum. Mm. Palmer's got something for everything, let me tell you. I go in with the serum, and this is just really adding that shine. And as you can see, I have like Susie Q curls, like they're really tight onto my head. So you're giving yourself whiplash, you gotta be careful because you're gonna have to do a few different shakes because you're trying to make your hair bigger, right? Then I'm trying to go in with my fingers, and I'm really going in at the root to just kind of pull it, pull a little bit before I go in with my afro pick. So then I'll go in with my pick, and this process is really just making the fro grow at this point. So you can try to preserve as much as you want. If you want that defined look, then you really want to concentrate on the roots, but it's going to sound like I'm like pulling my hair out of my scalp, so just be careful. Don't be harsh with it, be gentle, because you're literally, you're almost like straightening your roots at that point to make it bigger. Mm-hmm. And then I'll just work around my head and then kind of go to the ends and the top, just create the shape that you want. Mm-hmm. And then boom, bam, pow, you got a fro, darling.
Woo!
And then I'm done.
Nice.
I really love that we did this because I know that there's so many people that struggle with their process, don't know what products to use, and I learned a lot from both of y'all.
Me too! I learned a lot. We hope that you guys learned a lot, or that you can relate, or you're seeing the beauty in your hair, the way it naturally grows out of your head, which we love.
It's really nice to see so many brands and products, and there's a real serious shift in movement and culture and society where people want to celebrate our hair too. Yeah.